Well, they're very impressive advances in photovoltaics. They're coming along.
What's that?
That's the form of solar technology that doesn't heat water to make steam and turn turbines. That's called concentrating solar thermal, and that's going to play a huge role as well. But photovoltaics transforms the sunlight directly into electricity. There are new options, for example, in nanotechnology, to concentrate the sun's rays within the surface of the cell itself. There are new chemistries for these cells that are cheaper to make and more efficient in producing electricity. There are new advanced batteries that are extremely important because energy storage increases the usefulness of all renewable energy
options. And where are we in terms of dramatic developments in battery capacity?
We are moving very quickly there. There are a lot of new developments coming out of the universities and taken by entrepreneurs and shaped
into new
companies.
Will have a lithium capacity or not, you think?
Well, a lot of them
because
will.
Because of the danger that's come out of...
Well, lithium ion is a chemistry of choice partly because there is a global competition now to dominate the coming electric car industry. Every nation is moving in that direction. And lithium ion has been chosen by many of these electric car companies. So a lot of the storage companies are now
looking.
They're guessing that all of that R&D money from the auto industry is going to lead to more rapid advances. But there are lots of other new chemistries for batteries. And on the horizon, some potential breakthroughs that would really be dramatic.
Is it more likely to happen here or South Korea or Japan or China or somewhere else?
It's our choice. It depends on whether or not we put in place the policies that encourage these entrepreneurs to believe that the market is going to be here.
Join us online at charlierose.com.